Affordable rental housing, the next focus area of the Central Housing Ministry. This is the government's endeavor to make housing available to the lower income and economically weaker group of people. Essentially, what does this mean? That this group no longer has to buy low-cost homes, rather it can get them on rent from the government. Government will build them either alone or along with private developers. The question we are asking, why will this rental scheme be successful if the government hasn't got much of anything right when it comes to affordable homes at all? How will it guarantee that the rental scheme will work? Oinita Moja tries to get some answers.
The new buzzword in the corridors of the housing ministry is affordable rental housing. An ever-growing migrating population and the census of 2011's estimates that about 27.5% of the urban population live in rented accommodation prompted the central government to look at creating rental housing stock in partnership with the states and urban local bodies. The policy is in place and the government has started a pilot project in Chandigarh. As many as 7,627 rental dwelling units have been sanctioned in 25 states and are expected to be ready in a couple of years' time. Rent and eligibility criteria will be finalized by municipalities and urban local bodies on a no-profit, no-loss basis. States like Maharashtra and Gujarat already have their own rental housing schemes.
People who come to the cities don't have to go to a slum. And there is a rental housing available for them. So as a part of the Rajiv Abbas Yojana project, we have also sanctioned many municipalities' rental housing projects. And we also give the same kind of support to them, 50% of capital subsidy for larger towns and 80% of capital subsidy for smaller towns.
Inadequate supply of affordable housing is seen as a major reason for expansion of slums in and around metros and other cities. Low-income households typically cannot afford to buy homes and cannot get home loans due to lack of credit history. Smaller monthly rent payments suit their variable income profile, and therefore experts see this initiative of the government as a step in the right direction. This is expected to be beneficial for the government too, because subsidy outlays for rental housing, such as on rental allowances, are lower than subsidizing house ownership, and the housing asset remains with government, so it can be used by multiple households over time. But the rent law, both at the center and the states, will also have to be amended.
There have to be guidelines which should be very, very proper and well-defined guidelines, and it should be aimed at the actual beneficiary, and it should not be aimed at the discretion of the officers or the political system.
Given the magnitude of the